Farm work is hard work. It's good to relax when I can. But I still have to listen to my brother's heart about injustice.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something. In the old form, they rift it. I could see that.
I'm not sure why Talius is wasting his time trying to take Winterhold from us. But if he wants to throw his men away, I'll gladly accept that gift.
Speak with Ulfric. He's expecting word from Whiterun.
Save it for the battlefield.
Our men are getting massacred out there. Damn Imperials!
We can't march on Solitude. Not yet. One thing at a time.
We need to move faster. Keep them off balance.
It's working, Dalmar. Our patience has won us friends and allies, and our armies are systematically taking care of the rest.
Speak with
Ulfric. We should take Yarmark.
He's expecting word from
Whiterun. It'll be an important pressure point on the Imperials. We'd be within spitting distance of the capital. Not entirely true. Though not entirely false, either. Any Nord can learn the way of the voice by studying with the Greybeards, given enough ambition and dedication. My shouting tore to the ground proved he had neither. However, it was my sword piercing his heart that killed him. I killed Torek to prove our wretched condition. How is the High King supposed to be the defender of Skyrim if he can't even defend himself? Indeed, Elisif has become Jarl of Solitude. Historically and conveniently home of the High King, backed by Imperial interests. But the Moot has not yet met to name her High Queen, and they won't. Not as long as I have any say in it. There hasn't been a true High King in Skyrim for generations. For too long, he's been hand-picked by the Emperor, and given emphatic nods by milk-drinking Jarls addicted to Imperial coin. It's time we had a real High King, one of our own making. My father, the Great Bear of Eastmarch, died during my imprisonment after the Markarth incident. I, his only son, forced to deliver his eulogy via letter I had smuggled out of prison, such as the love of Titus Mead for his subjects. When finally set free, I returned to Windhelm and was greeted by a city in mourning, at one with my own grief and anger, clamoring in angry voices. Calling out for justice, for war, they sat me on the throne. The throne of Ysgrimor, the throne of my father. I only hope I can prove worthy of that honor.
We're fighting because we're done bleeding for an empire that won't bleed for us. Untold numbers of Nords died defending the Empire against the Dominion. And for what? Skyrim being sold to the Thalmor so the Emperor could keep his throne. We're fighting because our own Jarls, once strong, wise men, have become fearful and blind to the people's suffering. We're fighting because Skyrim needs heroes, and there's no one else but us.
The Imperials have already dug into Whiterun. We'll wrest it from them soon enough. We must. Its central position is key. Then I was wrong about him. You're right, Dalmar.
Again?
I'm in no mood to joke.
Give the word, my lord, and Whiterun is yours.
Whiterun is only a means to an end.
I've toured our camps. We're ready, Ulfric. Whenever you are.
Is any man ever ready to give the order? That will mean the deaths of many.
No, but neither is every man able to give that order when he must. But you are that man, Ulfric. You've been that man before, and you'll be him again. And these men and women, they call themselves Stormcloaks because they believe in you. They are the meanest, toughest sons of bitches Skyrim has to offer. And they want this. They want this as much as you do. Perhaps they want it more.
You're certain we're ready. Whiterun's army will no doubt be bolstered with legionnaires. And those walls around Whiterun are old, but they still stand.
We are ready. And I might be old myself, but I'll kick those damn walls down with my bare feet if you would only ask me to do it.
I'm sure you could do it too. All right. This is it.
Yes!
Send the word. A new day is dawning, and the sun rises over Whiterun.
Aye, and the sons of Skyrim will greet that dawn, teeth and swords flashing.
So it begins. Make haste to our cabin, Whiterun. I want you on the front lines. I have a feeling about you. Your place is on that battlefield. I need you there. Fight well or die well. Talos be with you.
We're taking the city. Meet the brothers gathering for the attack. Fight well or die well. Talos be with you.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. I've got a letter and a lot of gold. Something about it being your, inheritance. Oh, and sorry for your loss. Looks like that's it. Got to go. Thank you.
If you're here for sightseeing, well, then you've seen the sights. Might as well head somewhere more.
You survived. You have it, then? Let's hope it's as powerful as the Psijiks believe it to be. She didn't make it. When it was clear we were going to have to fall back, she stayed behind and made sure the rest of us were all right. Look for yourself. Ankano's power is growing. We can't crack whatever magic he's using to shield himself. I hope your trip to Labyrinthium was worth it. I'll be right behind you.
I'll be amazed if any of us survive this.
We never should have brought them.
Amazed if any of us survive this.
If only Savos were alive to see this. If only Savos were alive to see this.
Thank you. my power supreme.
I don't know. Ankano is gone, but whatever he's done to the Eye doesn't seem to have stopped. I have no idea what to do.
We knew you would succeed.
Your victory here justifies our belief in you. You have proven yourself more than worthy to guide the College of Winterhold. A great many things obscured to you are quite clear to us. We have long believed you would prevail. The Eye has grown unstable. It cannot remain here, or else it may destroy your college and this world. It must be secured. Onkano's actions prove that the world is not ready for such a thing. We shall safeguard it, for now. You now have the opportunity to maintain your college and carry on with your lives. You have our gratitude, Archmage.
You've done it. The college is safe again, thanks to your work. I knew you had it in you. I dare say the Psijiks are right. There's no one more deserving to be Archmage, in my opinion. Here, consider these yours, and the Archmage's quarters as well. I shall be here for advice, should you need me. Until next time.
I'm not one for commendations, but I might have lost everything that matters, so thanks. Archmage or not, my rules about books still stand. Looks like you're still in one piece, and more importantly, so is the book. Thank you.
Excellent. I'll start translating it. Shouldn't take me more than a day or two. There are more books to be recovered and secured in the Arcanium. Some other time, then. I only just got my hands on it. I can only work so quickly.
Are you feeling sick?
We have survived difficult times, and are better mages for it. We owe you that, Archmage. Thank you.
Yes, they have. I can feel the difference already. But, of course, I'm far more in tune with these sorts of things than most. Thank you. I appreciate your assistance. Good day.
Word is the College of Mages is back to normal. If there's such a thing.
Azura has seen your coming, traveler. It was not curiosity, but fate that has led you here. This shrine was built by the Dunmer. As our land was scorched by fire and brimstone, Azura's prophecies led us to safety. She is a Daedra, a powerful being who watches from beyond our mortal plane. She has chosen you to be her champion. You must go to a fortress, endangered by water, yet untouched by it. Inside, you will find an elven mage who can turn the brightest star as black as night. It is cryptic, I know, but Azura's signs are never wrong. I believe the fortress may refer to Winterhold. Ask if they know this elven enchanter. She is the goddess of dawn and dusk. Azura sees into the twilight of the future and guides her followers through it. My people, the Dunmer, built it. We fled from Morrowind after Vardenfell erupted almost 200 years ago. Those of us who were faithful to Azura were given a vision that led us away from the island before the worst came. This shrine is our thanks to her, that none will forget that she watches over us all. Yes, there were others at first, but Azura's visions tested everyone's faith. One by one, they left, afraid to know their own future. But I refuse to abandon the shrine. The visions are a gift. Azura warns me of tragedy, war, death. Before it happens, I won't leave her guidance. Twilight, guide your path.
This is it, men! They say that our cause is false, and that we are nothing more than thieves, thugs, and murderers! But no! We are farmers! We are craftsmen! We are sons and daughters of shopkeepers, maidservants, and soldiers! We are the sons and daughters of Skyrim! And we have come this far because our cause is true! Because we fight as one! And because our hearts are bursting with anger! What we do here today, we do for our country, for all the true lords of Skyrim. Oh, and crumbling, like the Empire whose legion lies here. They barricade to block us, but we'll tear through them and the Imperials behind them. Our objective is the drawbridge. If we can find a way to drop it, the city will be ours! Everyone on me! Let's show these Imperial Nilfgaarders what true Nords look like! Huzzah!
Thank you. up while you still can. Enough!
Enough. I surrender. I surrender.
Peace! Everyone stand down. That's an order. Stand down!
I surrender. Vignar Greymane. Your family was noticeably absent from the walls. Now I know why. Wouldn't the dagger in the back have sufficed?
You think this is personal? The Empire has no place in Skyrim. Not anymore. And you? You have no place in Whiterun anymore.
A convenient position to hold now. But mark my words, old man. In the days to come, Ulfric will spread his rebellion thin. And what then? We need the Empire as much as it needs us. We Nords are the Empire. Our blood built it. Our blood sustains it. You, of all people, should know that.
If this was my empire, I'd be whoever I damn well please. You wish to see an empire without Talos? Without its soul? We should be fighting those witch elves, not bending knee to them. The Emperor is nothing more than a puppet of the Thalmor. Skyrim needs a High King who will fight for her. And Whiterun needs a Jarl who will do the same.
Tell me, Vignar.
Was all this
worth it? How many of those corpses lining our streets wear the faces of men who once called you friend? What about their families?
Enough! Both of you! There is a burning city out there that needs a government.
He's right. Galmar, come. Let us restore order.
This isn't over.
Hear me, you old fool. This isn't over.
And you, Stormcloak. I thought better of you. You'll all come to regret this day.
Get over to Vendel. Tell Ulfric of our victory here. Get over to Vendel. Tell Ulfric of our victory here.
Everything's all right?
Galmar thinks we should double our men in the Reach.
A reasonable strategy.
And you, Yorleaf?
Well, sir, the hold of Falkreath is fairly vulnerable and blocks the only road from Cyrodiil.
A good point, old friend.
To be sure, my lord, I am not skilled in the arts of war or military tactics.
But you're able to see the hole in the parts, and for that I'm grateful.
As you wish, sir.
We've driven the Imperials out of Whiterun. This is good. Very good. We now control the center. It's a powerful position. One I aim to keep. We'll call you Ice Veins now. For the thick blood of our land has seeped into your heart. Here, take this. It's an Imperial officer's sword. A fitting weapon to use against our enemy. I suspect you'll be of greater use to us with greater freedom. So you're free to engage the Imperials as you see fit. But I also want you to find our hidden camp in Falkreath. Galmar will have special tasks for you, and will need you when we liberate the capital. You'll be doing whatever Galmar tells you to do, and causing as much mayhem as possible for the Empire and any Jarl who supports them. Talos guide you.